In lane one, we have the young Frenchman, Jimmy Vico, then Daniel Bailey of Antigua, Kim Collins of St. Kitts Nevis, Walter Dix of the USA, then the Jamaican trio, Usain Bolt, Johan Blake, and Nesta Carter, and finally the second Frenchman in the lineup, Christophe Lemaitre. Oh no, oh no, the whole crowd will go.
Wow,
because that was Usain Bolt.
Massive, massive disappointment. And he knows it too. The vest came straight off.
The whole of the photographers who assembled at the finish, ready to celebrate the moment, have now run down to the beginning of the race. He's whisked his shirt off immediately. He knows what he's done. When it came to the big moment, he's looked so impressive in the preliminary rounds here. And it's just not going to be for Usain Bolt, because surely he was away well clear of the rest of the field.
In this year's 100-meter World Championship final, no doubt about the culprit there. Dan Bailey went with him. That's the first time I've ever seen Usain Bolt false start.
I think he was trying for a magnificent performance, and we expect so much from him. That's what it is. He could have got an ordinary start and still won this race, but he wanted to produce something special, I think, and that's what caused it. What an absolute shame. I mean, this is going to make the headlines all over the world. Unfortunately for the one that actually wins it today, this is the man that's going to take the headlines.
They're away this time with no problem. A terrific start there by Kim Collins as well. Kim Collins is flying. Can he repeat his title? He's got Jamaican challenge, though. It's not going to be. It's the man in lane six. It is a Jamaican victory. And it is the young pretender, if you like, to that title, Johan Blake, who comes through to win the 100 metres. It's fast, it's 9.93, despite a very strong headwind of 1.4 metres per second. The great man wasn't there, but the young pretender took the title.
Johan Blake, as we saw in that semi-final, what a talent this young man is. Heir apparent maybe, but having said that, he might have to wait a long time. 9.92, a season's best, to come out on top in the end.
Well, what a climax today, too, of these World Championships. Disqualification of the fastest man in history, Usain Bolt, but the champion is still Jamaican.
Well, this is the final race, and look at Kim Collins in the red go there now. Blake in lane six, and to a slightly lesser extent, Walter Dix, but he's still behind Collins here. He comes past him, but Blake just goes away and away. But Nesta Carter, the other Jamaican, also tailed off at the back of the field. So not quite what the Jamaicans would have expected.
Let's not forget, of course, Usain Bolt will get a second bite of the cherry because he has the 200 metres to come. And I don't think he'll make the same mistake twice. But that is a lovely moment for Johan Blake. As you said, Steve, these guys now had the chance to grasp the medal and become world champions. And that's exactly what Johan Blake did.
Well, if you live in an era where someone dominates it as much as Usain Bolt, the chances of snatching any championship gold medal must be slim, so you must grasp it while you can, and this young man certainly did just that.
Well, there is the confirmation of the 100 metres final. Johan Blake winning by a clear margin in 9.92 to take the gold for Jamaica. Walter Dix of the USA, the silver medal, and Kim Collins taking his third 100 metres medal.